Hi guys! Salamat sa inyong patuloy na ginagawang pagsubaybay dito sa ating discussions about dynamics of rigid bodies. At ang ating magiging topic ngayon guys ay ito namang tinatawag nating kinetics of particles. At ako ay naghanda sa inyo ng tatlong problems para mas lalo nating maintindihan kung paano ba tayo mag-deal at mag-solve ng mga problems that involves with kinetics of particles. At simulan natin ito sa pamamagitan ng problem guys ano. So in the problem there is a system of connected bodies shown, and in here the pulleys are frictionless and of negligible weight. And we are required to find here what would be the weight of this block A that will give this block B to have a downward acceleration equal to 0.6 g. So, dito sa problem nito, we will be solving for the weight of the block A in order that this block B will be given a downward acceleration of 0.6 of the gravitational acceleration. So, siguro mas maganda guys ay pag-aralan ba natin kung ano ba yung mangyayari ano? Okay, with the system when the block moves ano, such that block B moves at a certain acceleration equal to A sub B or equal to 0.6 of G. So here is what will happen to the system. Okay, so ganyan yung mangyayari, no? Pakita ulit natin. So the B will now be subjected to an acceleration A sub B and whose magnitude is 0.6 of G. So what shall we do? Okay, so in order for us to be able to solve for the problem, okay, because it is mentioned in the problem that okay, the friction at the pulleys are frictionless, so we would expect that these tensions on the cables will be equal. So if we have here T sub 1, okay, we have here T sub 2, and then we have here T sub 3. Okay, assuming natin that itong part na ito is T sub 4. So dahil nga sinasabi dito na itong pulleys are frictionless, therefore what can we say about T sub 1, T sub 2, and T sub 3? Therefore we shall be expecting that T sub 1 will be equal to T sub 2 and equal to T sub 3. So, ganyan yung mangyayari. Ano? And assuming natin na siya ay equal to T. Similarly, itong T sub 4 natin will be equal to T sub 1 plus T sub 2. Ano? So, that is equal to T sub 1 plus T sub 2, and let that be called as 2T. So, what shall we do next? If we're going to isolate block B as F, block A as FBD, so, consider natin ito na okay, yung free body diagram itong block A, ano? So, let us now take that block A and let us try to show the forces acting on the block. So, meron tayo ditong weight of the block which is actually an unknown. So, let us just give this a symbol W sub A. This block is tied to a cable and the magnitude of the tension in the cable is not yet known. So, let us just call it T. Okay? So, the block will be subjected to an acceleration in the upward direction kasi nga, hahatakin siya nitong block B. Kaya, tawagin natin ang kanyang acceleration is A sub A. And because of this acceleration, expect natin na meron tayong tinatawag na unbalanced force which directed in the same direction as the acceleration. Kaya, kung yung acceleration natin is pataas, therefore, there should be an unbalanced force equal to KR, and the direction is also in the upward direction. So, where the summation ano, is the magnitude of this unbalanced force, of course, is the summation of the forces that would be acting vertically. And we can solve for that by taking the summation of all those forces acting vertically on this block A. So, if we will be solving for that R sub A, it will be equal to the difference between the tension and the weight of the block A. So this becomes our unbalanced force R sub A. So similarly, from Newton's law of motion, alam naman natin na kapag meron tayong unbalanced force, therefore that object or that body will be subjected to an acceleration na kung saan ang kanyang magnitude is the ratio of the unbalanced force divided by the mass of that body or that object. So that if we will be substituting this unbalanced force to this equation, therefore we will be having a term or an equation for the acceleration of the block A, and that is equal to t minus the weight of the block divided by the mass of the block. At alam naman natin na yung ating mass is equal to the ratio of the weight over gravitational acceleration g. Hence, we can substitute it further in our equation for A, that A will become equal to t minus W sub A over the ratio of W sub A over g. At tawagin natin itong our equation 1. Okay? So what shall we do next? Okay, now if we're going to isolate the block B as FBD, this time we isolate this block B as FBD, you know. So tingnan natin ating mga isolated view. We have here our block. This block is subjected to the pull of the earth equal to its weight, and the magnitude is equal to 200 pounds. It is tied to a cable, okay, that is directed upward, and the magnitude of the cable is given here to be equal to t sub 4. So the movement of this block is to move in the downward direction. So let us show, okay, this acceleration to be our a sub b, and is given to be equal to 0.6 of the gravitational pull of the earth. So, and because of the acceleration that is directed downward, so we will expect that, okay, the unbalanced force will be directed downward also in the same way as the direction of the acceleration. So we have here our unbalanced force, which can be solved, ano? Okay, by summing up forces vertically on this block. So if we will be summing up the force vertically acting on the block, makukuha natin ngayon itong unbalanced force on the block. And that, it will be equal to the difference between the weight and the tension acting on the cable T sub 4. And if this unbalanced force will be substituted, you know, from the Newton's law of motion, that acceleration on B is equal to the ratio of the unbalanced force, okay, divided by the mass. Hence, we shall have, okay, the equation for the acceleration of the block B equal to 200 minus t sub 4 over the mass of the block B. But again, alam naman natin yung ating mass is equal to the weight of the block over the gravitational pull of the earth. Hence, this will be equal also to the ratio of 200 over g. And if we are going to substitute the acceleration of a sub b, which is given to be 0.6, ano, as well as, okay, the value of t sub 4, which is equal to twice the tension, or 2 sub t. And our equation for acceleration will be equal to 0.6 of g equal to 200 minus 2t over 200 over g. And we can expect that this g will cancel, ano? Where this g will cancel. And from here, we can solve for the value of t to be equal to 40 pounds. So what shall we do next after we have solved for the value of t? So we can probably solve for the relationship, the kinematic relationship of the motion of this block A and B. And also, let us now try to work on this. So let us now try to determine the kinematic relationship among the motion of the blocks. In particular, I am referring to the relations between the acceleration of the block A and the acceleration of the block B. Because as they move, okay, there will be relationship between the displacement that they would have as well as their velocity and their acceleration. But we are concerned on their relationship between, okay, the accelerations. So let us now try to find out. Okay, and this can be taken if we're going to use the concept of the method of the virtual work. So ano ba yung tinatawag nating concept of the method of the virtual work? Yun yung tinatawag nating the total work done by the connecting forces on the system is equal to zero. So we will expect here that the total work done by this T, these are the connecting forces, di ba? Itong tineto will be equal to zero. And we know that this T acts on, okay, the weight of the block A and the block B. So we shall be finding what will be the work done by this T on blocks A and B. So pag-aralan natin, ano? So tingnan natin muna itong initial position of block A and block B. Assuming natin that here is the initial position of block A, itong nakaguhit na kulay blue, and then here is the initial position of the block B. Now, if we allow the motion of the block so that this will move in that direction, we see that we move a distance from this point to that point, and call this as the displacement by the block B. Similarly, we find that block A has moved a distance equal to S sub A, isn't it? But we see that the direction of the force acting on this block, particularly the tension acting on the block whose magnitude is equal to 2T, is directed upward. And the direction of the tension acting on a block A is also directed upward, having a magnitude equal to T. And we find that the work done by the force T upon block A, because the direction of the displacement is in the same direction of the force T, hence the work done shall be positive. However, the work done by the force T upon B, because the work done is directed upward while B moves in the downward direction, is considered to be negative because the displacement is opposite the direction of the force T. And we say therefore that summing up this work done, okay, this summation of the work done by the connecting forces on the system must be equal to zero. Therefore, we say that the work done on A minus the work done on B will be equal to zero. Hence, we say that T multiplied by S sub A minus 2T multiplied by S sub B is equal to zero. And so from here, T will cancel each other, diba? So we say that for that, the displacement of A is twice the displacement of B, or simply SA is equal to 2 of S sub B. Now, if this displacement will be differentiated with respect to time T, therefore our equation will become equal to the derivative with respect to time T of our S sub A being equal to 2 times the derivative with respect to time T of this S sub B. And we say that this derivative of S sub A is the exact definition of the velocity. Therefore, this equation can now be further simplified to be the velocity of A is equal to twice the velocity of B. And again, if this equation shall be differentiated with respect to time T, then the equation will be reduced further into the derivative with respect to time T of the velocity of A is equal to twice the derivative with respect to time T of the velocity of B. And again, this equation, the derivative with respect to time T of the velocity, is the exact definition of the acceleration. Hence, we say that this acceleration of A will be equal to twice the acceleration of B. So after we have established now the relationship between the acceleration of A and B, nakita natin na itong acceleration pala ng A ay twice dun sa magiging acceleration ng B. Therefore, what shall we do next? We now substitute the acceleration of B, which is given to be 0.6 of G. Nalalabas ang acceleration ng A natin is equal to 1.2 of the gravitational pull of the Earth. Then afterwards, if this acceleration will be substituted to the values in our formula that A is equal to T minus W sub A over WA over U, where the value of T is already computed a while ago, which is equal to 40, then where our equation becomes 1.2 of G is equal to 40 minus W sub A over W sub A over G. Now, if G will be cancelled here, we can simplify for the equation and find for the value of the weight of A, and the weight of A that we'll be getting is equal to 18.18 pounds. So this becomes now the weight of the block A that will give block B an acceleration equal to 0.6 of G. Sana sa pamamagitan itong aking sample problem, guys, ay nagkaroon na ng linaw sa inyo kung paano tayo mag-solve ng problems that deals with kinetics of particles. So, tutuloy natin ang ating problem with the problem number 2. So, ituloy natin, guys, itong ating problem. Dito naman tayo sa second problem. Na sinasabi dito sa problem na ito, meron tayong system of blocks here, A, B, and C. And sinasabi sa problem na if the coefficient of kinetic friction is 0.25 under each body in the system shown, how far and in what direction will body be moved in 5 seconds starting from rest? Actually, this was taken from one of our reference materials, and there is an answer in that reference material equal to 26.9 feet, and the direction is downward. So let us try to work on this problem at pag-aralan natin, no? So unang-unang dapat natin makuha dito, guys, ay malaman natin itong sinasabi nating possible kay motion of each of the block. Paano ba magiging galaw itong ating mga blocks A, B, and C? Okay, considering that they are connected with this cable at meron tayong coefficient of friction under each of the block na 0.25. Diba? So, ang isa sa mga magandang paraan para ma-define natin ay una, mag-assign muna tayo, mag-assume muna tayo na one of the blocks ano, is not moving. And we try to find out how okay, shall the other blocks be moving with respect to the other. So in this case, subukan muna natin na kunwari itong block B will be assumed natin na stationary. The question is, possible kaya na itong block C na nakikita natin dito ay gumalaw siya pababa, considering that this block B is heavier than that of the block A. At mahila niya pataas itong block A. So, yun muna yung ating pag-aaralan. Ano? Kinakailangan ma-define muna natin dito ano kaya yung magiging galaw nitong ating block C okay, relative to block A if block B will be assumed stationary. And to do it, this can be done ano, by isolating its block as free body diagram. And then, we determine the range of the values of the tension that would be acting on each side of the block okay, when the motion impends. So, when there will be tendency of the motion, ano bagay yung possible range of these values that may be acting on this cable? Kung sakaling gagalaw itong block pababa, o kaya naman, gagalaw siya pataas. Ano? Kaya, unahin natin itong block C na i-isolate. Ano? So, if this block will be moving in the downward direction, so ipakita natin yung mga forces that would be acting on this block. So, meron tayo dito una, yung kanyang weight ano, na 800 pounds. Okay, pangalawa, pakita natin itong kanyang axis na okay, yung axis na kung saan this axis is parallel to the plane. Okay, so consider natin that this axis is our x-axis. So that, okay, itong tension, itong cable nito na tinanggal natin will be exerting a tension on this block. So tawagin natin siyang T. Ano? Then, assume natin that an axis perpendicular to this x-axis drawn here, okay, yun din yung axis na perpendicular dito sa plane nito. At tawagin natin itong axis na y-axis. Ano? Kung kaya, meron tayong normal force na mag-act dito sa block that is exerted by the plane. Then, this force is directed along this y-axis at tawagin natin itong N of C, the normal force exerting upon this block C. So, itong angle na weight na no, will be making therefore equal to this angle theta, considering that the plane is also making the same angle with respect to the horizontal. Kaya itong weight natin will be making the same angle theta with respect to an axis perpendicular to the plane. So kung itong y-axis natin is perpendicular to the plane, sa makatawid itong ating vertical load, which is the weight of the block, will be making an angle of theta with respect to the y-axis. Ano? And this weight, of course, will have component if we will be resolving this 800 into components, one to be parallel to the y or, of course, perpendicular to the plane. And then the other one is the one that is parallel to the inclined plane, which is directed down the plane. Ito na. So, because of this, alam naman natin na kunwari, kung sakali na itong block will be moving in the downward direction, ay hanapin natin ano ba yung supposed to be the tension that this cable would be exerting upon this block. So, if this will be the direction of the motion, so we'll expect therefore that the force here or this plane will be exerting, a frictional force that will be opposite the direction of the motion. So, kung yung motion natin is downward, so itong frictional force that is exerted by the plane must be directed upward. So, tawagin natin itong component na ito as F sub C, and this will be equal to the product of the normal force multiplied by the coefficient of the friction. Ano? So, kinakailangan ma-solve natin kasi dito itong normal force. So, solve natin siya by summing up moments about this axis. Ano? So, kapag nag-take tayo ng moment dito, and assume natin na yung direction, ano, in this direction upward will be positive. So, mayroon tayong equation na NC minus the component of this weight that is along the Y, which is this axis, itong force na ito. This is equal to 800 cosine of theta. Kaya, these forces, when sum up, must be equal to 0, at makukuha ngayon natin itong ating N sub C. Kaya lamang, how much is this cosine of angle theta? So, kung babalikan natin itong angle na ito, mula doon sa ating original na problem, yung plane kasi is making an inclination of 3 vertical and 4 horizontal. Kaya sa makatwid, itong ating triangle na ito is actually a 3-4-5 triangle. So, kung ito ay 3-4-5 triangle, matidefine natin yung kanyang cosine of the angle theta, which is equal to the ratio of the adjacent to the hypotenuse. Kung yung hypotenuse dito is 5, then cosine of this theta will be equal to 0.8. Ano? At kapag sinubstitute natin itong 0.8 na ito sa equation na ito, so masosolve natin ngayon itong N sub C natin, whose value will become equal to 640. So after we have computed for this N sub C, or the normal force exerted by the plane upon the block, then we can compute for F sub C by multiplying that N sub C by the coefficient of friction. So itong ating F sub C will therefore be equal to 0.25 multiplied by 640. Kapag sinimplify natin ito, ang kanyang value will be equal to 160. This one will be equal to 160 pounds. So that if we are to solve for the T, considering that the block will tend to move downward, kung sosolve natin itong T ngayon, that if this block will be moving in the downward direction, so asahan natin na yung ating T by summing of forces along X equal to 0. So ano yung masosolve natin? So magkakaroon tayo ngayon ng value na T minus F sub C, diba? Minus the component of this weight, parallel to the plane, which is directed down the plane, itong component na ito, na ang value niya ay 800 sine of theta. Pero nga, itong ang sine of theta, base dito sa ating triangle na ito, will be equal to 0.6, itong 0.6 na ito. No? Now, if we will be substituting also the value of F sub C, na kinumpute natin kanina lang itong value na ito, in this equation, so magkakaroon tayo ng equation na T plus 160 minus 800 multiplied by 0.6 is equal to 0. And therefore, from here, masosolve natin itong value ng T na 320 pounds. So, ano nga itong ibig sabihin ng 320 pounds? Ano? Kinakailangan maunawa natin itong 320 pounds na sinasabi dito. Na kung pag-aaralan natin itong ibig sabihin niya, no? So, masasabi natin na when T is just equal to 320 gaya ng na-compute natin, ang ibig sabihin nun, the block will just tend to move downward. So, kung ito ay eksakto lamang sa 320, ibig sabihin, yung motion is just impending. It is just about to move in the downward direction. Sa makatwid, if we expect that this block will be moving in the downward direction, so ang ating value ng T should be less than 320 pounds. Because if it is just 320 pounds, then there will just be an impending motion. So, kaya ganun, dapat ito medyo mas maliit siya sa 320 kung siya ay inaasahan natin bababa. Pero, paano kung nabaligtad ang pangyayari kung ang motion ng block is in the upward direction? So, what shall we do? So, tingnan natin, ano? Now, if the block is to move upward, so ito pa rin yung kanyang forces acting, ano? Kaya lamang, ang kanyang magiging motion is upward. Ito yung magiging direction ng kanyang motion. At dahil baligtad ngayon yung kanyang motion, so asahan natin na mababaligtad din ang direction ng frictional force that this plane will be exerting upon this block. So if the motion is upward, then we expect that the frictional force F sub C here will be directed in a downward direction. And since we have already computed for the value, you know, the value of N sub C, yung N sub C, mananatili siya na 614 na gaya ng kinupit natin. Ganun din, mananatili pa rin na yung ating F sub C na 160 na gaya ng kinupit natin kanina. Itong value remains at 160, na baligtad nga lamang yung kanyang K direction. Okay, so that okay, if we wanted to compute for the value of T if the block will tend to move in the upward direction, therefore, how are we going to do it? So, we sum up forces acting along this direction, okay, which is the x-axis, equal to zero, for us to be able to solve and to know what would be the value of T for the block to have an impending motion in the upward direction. Kaya makikita natin that we have our equation T minus the frictional force A minus the coefficient, the component of this weight in the downward direction, okay? And that is equal to T minus F sub C minus 800 sine of K theta. And this should be equal to zero. So if we will be substituting again F sub C, okay, which is equal to 160, and sine of theta, which is equal to 0.6, therefore, we'll be getting a value of T, which is equal to 640. So, ano naman ang implication to? Ang ibig sabihin itong T that is 640. So, at this condition, okay, when T is just equal to 640, ang ibig sabihin nun, the block will just tend to move down upward. Sabihin, okay, it is just about to move upward. And for T to move actually, to have an actual motion upward, then T must have okay, a value greater than 640. So, anong ibig sabihin? Kanina, na-compute natin T is equal to 320 kung siya ay babagsak pa ba. At siya naman ay 640 kung siya ay mag-move pataas. So, makatwid, in between 320 and 640, ito ay hindi pwedeng magalaw. Diba? Gagalaw lamang siya kung ang T is greater than 640 at siya ay paakyat. At gagalaw din siya kung T is less than 320 at siya naman ay pababa. Any value okay, between okay, 640 and 320 will not cause C to move. Diba? So sa makatwid, kinakailangan natin malaman ngayon ano naman itong tension na madedevelop dito sa T considering that okay, A will be moving in the upward direction because we expect or we think that C will be moving in the downward direction. So pupuntahan natin ngayon yung part na yan. So hanapin natin ngayon dito yung minimum value of T needed to okay, for A to move in the upward direction, ano? To move up the plane. And so we isolate that block A as free body diagram. So kung kukunin natin yung block A, here is our block A. Okay, meron siyang weight na 600. Okay, at ito ay resting on a plane that is inclined at the same angle theta. Ano? Sabihin natin itong plane na ito, itong axis na ito, which is parallel to the plane, is called as our x-axis. Diba? So, at sa tension na ito, itong tension na ito, kay ipakita natin yung kanyang magnitude of T. Diba? So, we will be drawing an axis perpendicular to the plane at tawagin natin siyang y-axis, then this 600 okay, will have an angle of theta also with respect to the kay y-axis. Kasi nga, itong ating plane makes an angle of theta with respect to the horizontal. Hence, itong ating vertical load will be making the same angle with respect to the plane or to the axis perpendicular to the plane. And from there, mati-define natin yung kanyang component. Ano itong component niya? Ito yung component parallel to the plane. or along the x-axis. Samantalang itong component naman is the component perpendicular to the plane. So that, makikita natin dito that the force at the plane will be exerting now a normal force upon the plane. Tawagin natin siya na N sub A. Diba? At dahil nga inaasahan natin na itong ating block will be moving in the upward direction or up the plane, so ito yung kanyang direction of motion. Hence, we expect that the plane will be exerting a frictional force which shall be opposite the direction of this motion. So, meron ngayon tayo ditong frictional force that will be directed down the plane. So, tawagin natin siya Nf sub A. Diba? So, we can now solve for the value of N sub A by applying the condition of equilibrium, that is summing of forces along y equal to 0, so that from here, masolve natin ano na yung ating N sub A minus this component, which is equal to 600 cosine of theta. And this must be equal to 0. Hence, okay, knowing that cosine of theta, gaya na pinakita natin kanina, no, it is equal to 0.8. Hence, when this will be substituted, we shall have a value of 600 or Na minus 600 times 0.8 equal to 0, so that Na is equal to 480. Now, since there is friction here, so we can now compute for the frictional force that will be exerted by the plane by multiplying this normal force by the coefficient of friction. So that F sub A natin, itong value na to, no? K will be equal to F sub K multiplied by N of A. So that this will be equal to 0.25 times 480, then the value of F sub A is equal to 120. This value is 120. Now we cannot compute here for the value of T. Okay, if the block tends to move upward, makukompute natin ito, no? And that is by summing up, ano, summing up forces along x direction equal to 0. Take note na inahanap pa lamang natin dito is the value of T if it is to move. Ibig sabihin, tendency pa lamang ang kanyang motion, no? So makikita natin ngayon yung ating equation that T minus the component of the weight kay parallel to the plane, itong component na ito, no? Minus FA, itong FA na ito, is equal to 0. And if we will be substituting the value of FA, that is 120, and sine of theta, which is also 0.6 as seen in this triangle, no? So our equation becomes T minus 120 minus 600 times 0.6 equal to 0, so that we shall have a value of T equal to 480. So ito ngayon yung ating nakitang value na mahatak lamang itong A. Take note, mahatak lamang yung A kung ang value ng T is 480. Ba? 480. Kaya, ano ngayon naman nangyayari? Sabi dito, for block A to be pulled up, the value must be greater than 480. Diba? But as analyzed kanina, kay block C will move. If T is less than, kay move downward. Ito kay move downward. If T is less than 320. So, mahatak lamang niya ito kapag ito ay less than. But we need 480 dito, di ba? Sa sinasabi, kinakailangan magkaroon ng 480 para mahatak mo yan. So, makatawid, considering the weight only of the block C, di ba? Anong makikita natin yun? Anong conclusion makikita natin dito? So, sabi dito, therefore, it is not possible for block C to move down and pull block A up the plane. Kasi nga, 320 lamang ang kinakailangan tension dito para siya mag-us-us dito, mag-slide down pababa. Pero kinakailangan mo naman ng 480 para mag-slide up itong A pataas. So makatuwid, hindi magagawa ni C na hilahin ngayon itong A. And hence, we cannot say that or it is not possible for C to move down the plane and pull up the block A. Ibig sabihin, if we will keep this block B okay, stationary, then A and C will not be moving also. Yun ang ibig sabihin. Yun ang findings na nakikita natin. Diba? So, makatwid, ano ngayon ang ating magiging conclusion? So, it is not possible for C to pull A, then the other possibilities could be, ano? So, we can have other possibilities na pwedeng mangyari. So, ano yun? Pwedeng mangyari na both blocks A and C are pulled by the block B. Pwedeng mangyari na hindi kayang hatakin itong C, C, A pataas, Eh, baka mangi, baka naman pwede na itong ANC ay hinahatak pa ba itong Block B na siyang sinasabi ko dito sa ating first na possible na mangyari. O pangalawang pwede yung mangyari, eh, yung Block C. Itong Block C naman will remain stationary such that A is being pulled by Block B. So, pwede rin mangyari yun, ano? Case na A ang mangyayari, hindi gagalaw itong C at ang gagalaw lamang is B downward at inahatak niya pataas si Block A. O kaya naman, okay, walang nangyayari motion sa kabuuan sa tatlong blocks. Di ba? So, how are we going to determine therefore the actual and the final condition of the motion? So, let us now try to consider, okay, assuming that both blocks A and C will move up at hinahatak ngayon siya nitong ating kay Block B. Na gaya na pinapakita dito, there is this acceleration of this Block A up the plane, there is acceleration of this Block C up the plane, and there is an acceleration of this Block A downward. So ito yung kay possibly mangyari ano after kay knowing that C cannot move. Okay, cannot move downward. So, ito yung posibleng mangyari. Ipakita natin. So, yan yung possible mangyari. Let us try to do it again. Pakita ulit natin yung mangyayari. So, gumalaw ngayon, hinatak ngayon, itong A and C, K by the Block A. Pero, posible nga kayang ganyan na mangyari. So, malalaman natin yan kapag inanalyze natin isa-isa uli itong mga blocks. Ano? So, ano ngayon ang hanapin natin dito? Hanapin naman natin dito yung relationship ng acceleration, okay, and then we find, okay, what would be the tension on each of this cable, considering that T1, T2, T3, T4 are all the same because okay, pulleys here are assumed to be frictionless. So, what shall we do next? So, kinakailangan kay maunawaan natin na yung ating value is can be computed. May pinaluwanag ko na kanina, if we will be assuming here that the pulleys are frictionless, therefore T1, T2, T10, T4 are all the same, and let us assume that they are all equal to T. And that itong T5 na nakita natin dito will be equal to the sum of T2 and T3, and this can be assumed to be equal to 2T. Diba? So ituloy natin. Now if you are going to isolate now, okay, again, the blocks to establish the relationship between the tension and the acceleration, this time, ang magiging purpose natin ay para maraman naman yung relationship between the acceleration and the tension. So, i-isolate ulit natin yung each of the block. Ano? So, unahin ulit natin itong Block A. Pinakita ko na yung mga forces acting dito. So, ulitin ko, ano? Ito yung ating tension kay acting on kay the block. Here is the weight, and these are the components of the weight parallel and perpendicular to the plane. Ano? So, ito yung ating normal force, and since it is assumed that the block A will move upward, so yung kanyang frictional force exerted by the plane upon this block is in the downward direction. And here is the acceleration that is shown to be in the upward direction. So what shall we do? We'll find here the unbalanced force. This is to move, okay? So we find the unbalanced force, ano? So alam natin na yung NA will not change. That remains 480, as well as this FA remains 120. And so, okay, there will now be an unbalanced force, ano, which is equal to RA, which will be equal to okay, the sum of KT, okay, minus this FA, minus this component, which is equal to 600 sine of theta. Ito yun, pinapakita ko dito. Kaya kapag isimplify natin, yung ating unbalanced force becomes equal to T minus 180, minus, I'm sorry, 120 minus 360. So that RA is equal to T minus 480. Ito ngayon yung unbalanced force na mag-act dito if kay A will move upward. And because of that unbalanced force, so inasahan natin ano, na meron tayo ngayong acceleration being equal to the ratio of the unbalanced force over the mass. Okay, so this becomes now T minus 480 divided by 600 over G. Considering that this 600 over G is the mass of A. So, for Block C naman, dito naman tayo sa Block C, ano? So, drawing ko na rin yung Block C, ipinakita ko na rin. Ano? Here is now the weight, okay, the components of the weight, parallel to the plane and perpendicular to the plane, the normal force exerted by the plane, the frictional force, which is directed downward because hinahatak ngayon, ang assumption natin, hinahatak si C pataas up the plane. So, as shown by this acceleration. Hence, the frictional force will be directed down the plane. So, in this case, na-compute natin kanina itong NC, di ba? And the value is 640. So, makatawid itong F sub C natin will be equal to 160. That is 0.25 multiplied by the 640. Di ba? So, kailangan ma-define natin dito itong unbalanced force. Ano? So, yung unbalanced force natin will be the difference between this T, this weight, component of the weight, okay, parallel to the plane, and the frictional force exerted by this plane upon the block. And so that is T minus F sub C minus 800, and this is 800 sine of theta. Now, if F sub C, which is 160, shall be substituted as well as the value of sine of theta, therefore, R sub C okay, is equal, therefore, to T minus 160 minus 480, or simply, this is equal to T minus 640. With this unbalanced force now, this will create an acceleration A sub C, which is the ratio of that unbalanced force, diba, divided by the mass of that C. And therefore, it will be equal to T minus 640 over 800 K divided by the gravitational pull of the G. And for the block B, so ito naman block B na ipakita natin, diba? Yung ating block B has a weight of 1,200. And there is a tension here, ito yung T5, ng value is 2T, di ba? 2T yan. And B will move downward. So, meron tayong acceleration in downward direction. And because of this, okay, we can compute for that okay, RA, okay, that will cause this acceleration being the difference between 1,200 and this 2T. So, I have here RA equal to 1,200 minus 2T, which will cause now an acceleration equal to the ratio of this unbalanced force divided by the mass. Hence, we have here A sub B equal to 1,200 minus 2T over 1,200 over G. Diba? So, pagkatapos natin ma-define itong ating acceleration ng A, acceleration ng C, at acceleration ng B, all expressed in terms of T. So, kinakailangan natin dito ma-define ay yun namang relationship between the accelerations of A, B, and C. Diba? So, kinakailangan natin ma-define dito. Sabi dito, we now solve for the relationship between the accelerations using the concept of virtual work on the system by the connecting forces. Alin nga ulit itong virtual work? Sinasabi na the summation of the work done on the system must be equal to zero. And the sign of the work will be defined by how is the body move, di ba? Due to the force acting on the block. Ano? So, mapapansin natin na since yung ating acceleration, itong ating A, will be moving in the upward direction, okay, in the same direction as T, therefore, it will be positive, and its magnitude is T times S of A. Ito naman ating KC, will be moving in the upward direction, okay, in the same direction as T, therefore, the work done will also be positive, and the magnitude is T multiplied by the displacement of the C. Okay, I have here T multiplied by S of C, while the work that will be done on block B will be in the opposite direction because this upward, while the displacement will be in the downward direction, therefore that would be negative. Ano? So when we substitute that and transport it to the right, this becomes equal to 2t multiplied by s sub b. Kaya dito makikita natin, all these t's will cancel and we get a relationship between their displacement that s sub a plus s sub c is equal to twice of s sub b. Now if this s sub a will be differentiated, ano, with respect to time, will give okay, the relationship between their velocities, ano? So that our relationship becomes V sub A plus V sub C is equal to 2 of V sub B. And again, if this equation will be differentiated with respect to time T, then we'll be getting now the relationship between the accelerations of the block. So that the accelerations of the blocks will be A sub A plus A sub C is equal to twice of A sub B. At itong ating relation ito, okay, ito yung magde-define ngayon sa atin ng tension at magsasabi sa atin kung yung bang in-assume nating direksyon ay talaga bagang hinahatak ni Block B itong ANC in the upward direction. Kaya kapag sinubstitute natin yung ating acceleration ng A, which is taken a while ago, equal to T minus 480, divided by 600 over G, ano? Ganun din itong ating A sa B, na 1,200 minus 2T over 1,000 over G, and our acceleration C, which is equal to T minus 640 over 800 over G. In this equation, therefore, we shall have our equation, substitute ko na lang siya dito, okay, at saka yung ating 2 of A sa B. So, when this is simplified, itong ating G will cancel, okay, kaka-cancel yan, at masisimplify, pag simplify natin yan, masosolve natin yung T na A576. Okay. So, bago ako magtuloy, gusto ko munang magkaroon tayo ng konti pang analysis. Babalikan natin yung ating na discovery kanina, no? Sa kasi kanina binabanggit natin na we have just computed na for C to move ano upward, the value of T must be greater than 640. Okay? 'Di ba? But because T is less than 640, as a matter of fact, it is just 576. So ano ibig sabihin to? Ibig sabihin, hindi kayang hilahin pababa itong B, itong ating block C, 'di ba? Because okay, the only T that can be produced if B will be moving downward is only 576, yet ang kinakailangan nating T may higit sa 640 para yung ating block C is moves upward. So makatwin, anong conclusion ang meron tayo? Hindi kayang hatakin ni block B si block C pataas. Sabi nga dito, block C cannot be pulled up the plane. O diba? So kung hindi magagalaw ngayon si C, ano ngayon ang nangyaring condition of motion? So ipakita natin yung condition of motion. Therefore, the actual condition of motion is that C remains stationary while B is pulling up the block A. So nakita natin na C remains stationary habang hinahatak ni B itong block A pataas. So ipapakita natin ngayon. So, ang mangyayari pala ganito, no? So, in-assume natin kasi ganina ito ay tataas, pero hindi pala mangyayari ito na A ay tumaas kasi, kinakailangan meron dito tension na 640. Pero ang kayang ma-develop lamang, the tension dito is only 576, kaya ito mananatiling stationary. At ang ganito lang ang mangyayari. Kapag maggalaw siya, kay ang gumalaw lamang ay yung dalawa. So, C remains stationary. Okay? So, if this will be the condition of flow, so what will happen now to our equation? Equation now, mababago. Yung ating work done will only be due to the work done on the two blocks A and B. Diba? And if this will be substituted to the virtual world, sabi yan, we solve now for the relationship between the acceleration using the concept of the virtual work. Okay? That is the summation of the work done on the system is equal to zero. But the work that is only done on the blocks A and B. So that we say that the T okay, multiplied by S on the block A is equal to twice of T multiplied by S on the block B. And again, if T will cancel, we can say that SA is equal to 2 of SB. So makatwid, okay, with this relationship, if this will be differentiated with respect to time T, so makakakuha tayo ng relationship that the velocity at A is twice the velocity at B. And again, if that equation will be differentiated with respect to time T, then we'll be getting the relationship that the acceleration at A is equal to twice the acceleration of B. Hence, if okay, the formula for A will be substituted as we have okay, computed a while ago, then our okay, expression or equation becomes okay, T minus 480 over 600 over G, this actually is our acceleration for A, is equal to twice of the acceleration of B, which is 1,200 minus 2T over 1,200 over G. And from here again, okay, we can solve for T, that T is equal to 560. Now, if T is 560, what shall we do with this? We substitute this T either to our acceleration of A or B to solve for the acceleration. So, solving for that in our acceleration, okay, B, acceleration in B, so we have here AB equal to 1,200 minus 2T over 1,200 over G, that our acceleration will be equal to 2.14 6.67 feet per second squared. Then after, okay, we have computed for this acceleration, we now can compute for the displacement using the formula that s is equal to v sub of t plus 1/2 of a t squared. That since it is assumed to be starting from rest, this will be equal to 0 plus 1/2 of 2.1467 times 5 seconds squared. Hence, s is equal to 26.83 feet. And that's the answer to the problem that we have shown a while ago. So I hope, guys, that with the sample problems that I have presented to you in kinetics of rigid bodies, you are able to understand, you know, how to deal with them, and hope that the next problem that you will encounter ay masosolve nyo na, ano? So sana, guys, ay patuloy nyo akong subaybayan sa mga future ko pang mga uploads about the different topics and different subjects. So by subscribing to this channel, and if possible, share it to your friends so that your friends would know also of this kind of lecture. Once again, thank you very much for watching.